het de Kanya. The problem is, in these days, many guitars don't know the difference. And maybe also singers. Between Polo and Kanya. Because it, in some ways, it is similar, this thing. But the Polo is... And the Kanya... Different. The Kanya is more brave than the Polo, but it's the same. It is a brother and sister, and you have to play it also not like a Soljazz. Do never like this. Not a Soljazz. It is the same compass. Many chords are the same. There's another song. Other character, so it is different, and the way of playing not too much with this. Never this is the Kanya. Never. It is more. It are Soljazz falsetas, old falsetas. I think, thanks to the singer Antonio Chacon, or Don Antonio Chacon, we are singing the Kanya, because he recorded many songs. And he was taking care about the flamenco. At the same time, he was a great singer, taking care with an historical sense. He had a historical sense, and he was recording many songs. And Ramon Montoya was his guitarist many years. And after Montoya came Perico de Lunar. He was replacing him many times. At the end, I think it was only with Perico de Lunar. I don't know, but. And Perico de Lunar learned many things from Chacon and other singers. So Perico de Lunar, as Enrico Morente said to me, Perico de Lunar is also a flamenco singer, not with his voice, inside, and humming. He was humming then. And he teached the Kanya to Rafael Omiro. So he was teaching all flamenco songs, and they recorded it, as I said before, the old flamenco testament, Antologia del Canto Flamenco, was an international rescue, because many songs, the flamenco was declining in the 50s, so many songs like the Petaneras, Marianas, Aboreas, Rondeñas, Javeras, Kanya, Polo, Serranas, Livianas, well, it was almost forgotten. As in these days, the same thing occurs. And in the former days, there was many fandangos, fandanguillo. In these days, it's tangos, rumbas, burrias. There is more in the flamenco. Malagueñas, graninas, tarantas, many songs. So, I remember very well when I was in Madrid, I came in 69 with my scholarship for studying with Nino Ricardo. And I learned from Nino Ricardo many things, of course, falsetas and other things. But from Enrique Morente I learned accompaniment. And I went many times to his house in Carabanchel. I lived in Carabanchel, in a modest house. And it was an apartment, piso. And we were preparing a performance. And he said to me, Humberto, I go to sing the Kanya. And I didn't know the Kanya, and he teach me the Kanya. In both Bacher, not singing very loud, but low voice. So I learned the Kanya. And after Morente, I learned also many things from Antonio Meringuito. He was also singing the Canya. He went to the Netherlands and then he made some performance and some trips, and he was singing many old songs, and I learned many songs thanks to Morente and listening to this. So it's very important, listening to old stuff, my friends. So, well, you go to listen now, the Canya, sung by Rafael Romero, and the guitar, Perico de Lunar. I go a little as the chords, it's like a soliage, the same compass, it is similar, but you have to learn it by heart, so listen many times.
Thank you.
friends, this was the last song regarding the family of the Solares. And we go now to the Sigrias. Also a very basic song, beautiful song, and the Serranas also. There's a lot to do, a lot to learn. But the question is, what do you want? And you can say, well, I only like to listen to flamenco. A listener, also important. And for to listen very well, you also need knowledge. You can enjoy, but some knowledge is also necessary. You can say, well, I play the guitar, I play only solo the guitar. Very good, no problem. But in the moment you say, well, I want to be a guitarist, an all-around guitarist. Well, you have to know, working with dancers, singers, dancers and singers at the same time, playing solos, all these things is very important. Little dancing is also very good at the end of the show. Performance, little burrias, normally dancing burrias, not too bad. Also as a guitarist, to learn singing, not too bad, always good. But for accompaniment, it is good to have knowledge about, I think, almost all the flamenco songs. Solares, Sigrias, tangos, malagueñas, cartageneras, graninas, berdiales, all these songs, burrias. But there are different styles in tangos and malagueñas and graninas, many styles, you have to know all the styles. Nino Ricardo said to me, when I listening to a singer, and by the first, oh, I know, this is a Malagueño from Trini, or Chacón, or Peñaranda, or Mellizo. It's very important. So, this studying. And the only thing that you have to have, willing to do it, passion, the only thing. If you want to be an all-round guitarist, you have to learn Spanish, at least the basis. You have to go to Spain to make friendships, other guitarists, singers. Go to the Peñas, go to the festivals of flamenco. What can I say? If you have time, money, I don't know, it's expensive. But the first thing that is important, you want it. Because I began without any money. And I was lucky to have a scholarship. So I was playing that exam. Oh, and I was very happy. But even without scholarship, I had reached my goal. So with some small money, let's say a small wallet in Netherlands, I went to Spain before learning and listening. This is the most important thing. You have to have love, passion, to want. You have some talent, or at least sensitive to music. It's enough. I had no any idea about rhythm, compass. I was very bad in compass and rhythm, all the things. I was working, persistent. You have to be persistent. Well, my flamenco friends, flamenco knights, let's go to the Sigrias. Hasta luego.